Hey guys, today I present to you the logic part of the world map. As you saw in the last video, we basically finished the school part of the world map. So all the islands are in, most of the buildings are in, or the levels that you can go to. And yeah, now we worked on the logic part, so basically the level selection. In case you didn't know, a lot of people still ask that in the comment section. This isn't an open world. This is basically just a level selection screen with a 3D world map that you can fly through. So it's big and it's something like the world map in Into the Inferno, but much bigger and much more involved. So yeah, that is why the detail level is also that low. And I know it's not all 1-to-1, 100%, because if we would do that, we would work years on this world map, and I don't want to do that because I want to do other levels too. So yeah, basically on the world map, you can fly everywhere. You can only select the levels that you are eligible to actually select. So if you have beaten level 1, you can fly to level 2, and vice versa. If you have beaten level 2, you can fly to level 3. And of course, you can always fly back to level 1 or level 2 or whatever, and basically re-explore the area. So you can always go back after you visited, for example, Omashu. You can go back to the Southern Water Tribe and explore there too. If you press touchpad on the world map, you open up a menu where you can select all levels that you are eligible to actually select, and you can switch through them. You see a little description of the level. For now, we only have placeholder descriptions there, and you can look at the location if you press square, and you can actually auto fly there. If you press triangle, it then enters a kind of cinematic camera and you fly there automatically until you arrive. And when you arrive, you only have to press X to start the level. Of course, if you don't want to fly, or if this is all too slow for you, you can just select the level out of the menu if you press X. And of course, you can fly everywhere manually and just select the level. In the stream, we also plan to show some collectibles in the screen, so how many collectibles you've gathered in each level. But since we don't have any collectibles yet, we will include that later when we actually know what collectibles we will have. This world map is also now playable with the glider test level that we already uploaded. So if you have dreams and played the minigames or the glider test level, you will now find this world map and can explore this freely. The next logical step would be, of course, to add Team Avatar on the back of Appa, also Momo that flies around Appa and lands on Appa when he's not flying and such. First of all, we're gonna finish the Southern Water Tribe though, since we hold that Fire Nation ship way back. So we will finish that first and connect all the levels in the Southern Water Tribe and finish that up so we can work more on Aang and soonish the Southern Air Temple. This world map project was super fun, and I will definitely add more details over the time and more animations and stuff. For now, Bussing Sea has a little train that drives around, and the Northern Air Temple has some gliders that are flying around. The Zivong Desert also has some sand flying around. But yeah, we will add more of this stuff as we go. And as I have planned this world map will be for book 1 only. And for each book, we will have basically the same map, but with the different levels. Otherwise, I can't fit everything in that one level, and I think it will also be a little bit too cumbersome. And since we basically have to release this in dreams, in 3 dreams, so 3 games more or less, we can't go really around this fact. So yeah, I'm very happy how it turned out. We also added nighttime and stuff, and we also added a system in which we can change all variables of the sky and the visual stuff. So for specific episodic moments, we can also have some different visual styles on the world map itself. And yeah, that's it for today. Stay safe, wash your hands, and see you in the next video or stream. I stream every Monday, Thursday, and Saturday at 6 p.m. CEST or 9 a.m. PDT. And yeah, see you there, and have a good one. Bye-bye.